الأشاعرة أشاعرة are the followers of a madhab of doctrine called the Ash'ari madhab. This follows the name of Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari. Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari used to be misguided for 40 years, following what the whole ummah believe to be misguided, and this is the cult of al-Mu'tazila. He used to be following al-Mu'tazila for 40 years. Mu'tazila are those who deny Allah's attributes, who deny the punishment of the grave, who deny that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is over his throne. They followed a worst cult before them, which is called Jahmi cult. Those Mu'tazila used to be refuting the philosophers. Also, they used to be also, they were affected by the philosophers. Because they refuted the bid'ah with another bid'ah. They based their knowledge or their system, the system of their cult, on what we call ilmul kalam, the argument way of arguing. It follows the Greek kind of system regarding the matters of metaphysics, theology. So, Mu'tazila were better than the philosophers, yet they were also misguided. And Abu al-Hasan used to be with them for 40 years, and suddenly he said, "Whoever know me, here I am. He who does not know me, I am Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari. I used to be following the Mu'tazila for 40 years, and today I declare following the way of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal." Ahmad ibn Hanbal is the one who stood in big sabr, patience, against the Mu'tazila. The Mu'tazila used to be persecuting those who disagree with them, inciting the leader al-Ma'mum, Abbasite period of time, inciting him against them, provoking him to put them in jail. Many they were killed, many they were etc. They used to believe that the Quran is created by Allah. Created is not the word of Allah, but it is the created word of Allah. They don't say it's not the word of Allah, they say it's the created word of Allah. So they had a lot of problems, and Ahmad ibn Hanbal was going against them. He said to them, "Allah said, 'Innama qawluna li shay'in idha aradnahu an naqula lahu kun fayakun.' Our matter is that we say to the thing, 'Be,' we say, 'Speak,' we say, 'Be,' and it becomes." So Ahmad said to the Mu'tazila, "How Allah create things by a created thing? Because the word 'be,' we can't say this is created. If the word 'be' is created, so does Allah create things by a created word?" This was the evidence of Imam Ahmad against the Mu'tazila. All the scholars today, they believe that Mu'tazila are dalloon, misguided. And there was an argument about them being kafir or not kafir. And also, they believe that Allah does not know the thing unless it happens. And they said, the man create his actions by himself. Allah has nothing to do with this. Because of the doubt they have that if they say Allah knows about that, that means Allah dictated it, etc., etc., etc. So Imam Abu Hasan al-Ash'ari, he dissociated himself from them, saying, "I give them up, I don't follow them anymore, I follow the way of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal." Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal believes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks with a voice that can be heard, a voice that can be heard. And he based that on many evidences, such as we find in Sahih Bukhari, that Allah, at the Day of Judgment, will be speaking by a voice that will be heard by those who are close as those who are wide. or it will be heard by those who are wide as it will be heard by those who are close. So Imam Ahmad believed that Allah speaks by a voice that can be heard. Now today the Ash'aris, they say, no, that's haram to be believed. And Imam Ibn Hajar, in his book Fath al-Bari, he mentioned the difference between the Ash'aris and Ahmad Ibn Hanbal. He said that Ahmad Ibn Hanbal believed that Allah speaks with a voice that can be heard, but the Ash'aris disagreed with him. But wait a minute. We said before that Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari followed Imam Ahmad. And he said, my way is the way of Ahmad ibn Hanbal. So are the Ash'aris Hanbalis? As Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari became Hanbali, many people don't know this fact. It's a hidden fact, especially for those who speak English, they don't know anything. They only say, we heard about something called Ash'aris. We don't know what is that Ash'aris, but we believe we are Ash'aris. Because our fathers were Ash'aris, Deobandis, etc. So we are Ash'aris. So Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari wrote his book Maqalat al-Islamiyin after he left the Mu'tazila. And he wrote another book called Al-Ibana an Usul al-Diyana. He gave his declaration of faith. He said, Ahl al-Hadith is the way I believe in. Not anymore with those Mu'tazila. Especially those Ash'aris today, they have taken the same Greek divine, the Greek system about divinity. They inherited it from the Mu'tazila. Yet they are opposing the Mu'tazila. But they are still using the same philosophic analogy called Ilmul Kalam. And Imam Shafi'i. Imam Abu Hanifa, who was before following this, and afterwards he declared his dissociation from that belief. Imam Shafi'i, Abu Hanifa, Malik, Ahmad, they all agreed that this Ilmul Kalam, philosophical way of system belief, it is haram to be taught. It is haram to be followed. Those who follow it are following bid'ah. The four scholars, and I have full documents, proofs about what they said against Ilmul Kalam. So the Ash'aris are following the philosophical way, basics and rulings, which the Mu'tazila used to be following. And this is the source of what the Mu'tazila have is also came to them from the philosophers. So this is misguidance. The way of Ahmad ibn Hanbal is the way of Ahlul Hadith, the people of Hadith, who follow the Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They don't follow these philosophical ways. These cults who have been inheriting the philosophical virus. Abu Hasan al-Ash'ari. I mean, it's sufficient that Abu Hasan al-Ash'ari, after following the Mu'tazila for 40 years, he said, I dissociate myself, I'm free of them. I never follow their way anymore. But what we see today, the Ash'aris, who take the name of Abu Hasan al-Ash'ari, they are imitating the Mu'tazila. For example, the Mu'tazila believe that Ar-Rahman wa ala al-Arsh istawa. They say it means istawla ala al-Arsh, he grabbed, he prevailed the throne. Oh really? So before he, because the verse says, Allah is the one who created the heavens and the earth in 6 days and then he went over his throne. Now those Mu'tazilis, they said he controlled it. So that means it was out of his control before. And that's blasphemy. It is blasphemy. Now the Ash'aris today, like Al-Juwayni, Al-Razi, many who are Ash'aris scholars, big scholars, they said that it means istawa ala al-arsh, that means istawla ala al-arsh. They added lam as the Jews. When they were ordered to say hitta, then they added letter noon, they say hinta. They were mocking. Allah ordered them to enter the gate while making sujood, and they should be saying hitta, that means, oh Allah, forgive our sins. They started to mock Allah and saying, He ordered us to say Hitta, but we're going to say Hinta. Hinta means a piece of the floor. The piece of the floor. Just like Qamh. So the Ash'aris, when they ordered to say Istawa ala al-Arsh, they added letter Lam. They said Istawa ala, it means Istawla ala. As the Jews added letter Noon, the Ash'aris and the Mu'tazila before them, they added letter Lam. So Istawa became Istawla. As the Jews added letter Noon, they made Hitta as Hinta. This is falsehood. And this is the imitation of the Mu'tazila under the name and the banner of Ash'ari Madhab. Not only this, but many, many attributes of Allah, such as Allah has hands, two hands, as He said to the devil, what had stopped you from bowing down to the one I have created by my two hands? In Surah Al-A'raf. Not in Surah Al-A'raf, another one. I think Surah Sad, Allahu A'lam. He said, what had stopped you from bowing down to the one that I created by my two hands? The Mu'tazila said, two hands means power. The Ash'ari said the same thing. The Prophet said that Allah gets down at the last part of the night to the lowest heaven. And they said, this hadith means its mercy is going down. So Allah does not show His mercy except at the last night. Don't you reason? The mercy of Allah is coming down from Allah by day and night, even every second. But this is a special thing for those who stand at night in prayer. Allah offers His forgiveness. Allah offers His help for those who seek His help at the last part of the night. Otherwise, it's going to be meaningless to believe that Allah's mercy is always falling down on His servants, not only on the last third part of the night. And if we say that the two hands of Allah means power, can you say that Allah has two powers, pair powers? Just like saying that the airplane has two engines. So maybe one of them will be off, then the other one will be switched on. What is this? And if the hand means power, then the devil would have been saying to Allah, and you created me also by your two hands, which are the power. So what is the significance of Adam over me? But Allah wanted to show Adam's significance over the devil by saying that He created Adam by His two hands. Because the devil said to him, I was created by fire, Adam was created by dust, I'm more significant. But Allah showed him the significance of Adam over him. But Allah created him by His two hands, which means He did not create the devil by His two hands. Another type of creation that Allah may say, be, just like that. And the devil had become. But the hand is not, the power is not only the hand. If I say that my hand is my power, the power is not only my hand, the power can be on my leg as well. I have power in my leg. But the word hand has more specification. It specifies the type of the power Allah is talking about, is the hand. And you cannot, when you talk about two hands, pair yadan, bi yaday, it must never mean the power, because the power is a general word. Allah has one power in general. You can't say Allah has two types of powers, two parts of powers. You're making Allah as parts when you say that. You run away from believing that Allah has parts, but you're adding two parts to Allah. You're saying, first part is the first power, second part is the second power. What is this? So, as we find today, the Ash'aris are following the Mu'tazila in their interpretation of the attributes of Allah. under the banner of Abu Hassan al-Ash'ari, and Imam Ahmad was an enemy to the Mu'tazila. And now those people, they are taking, this is a mockery in itself, they're taking the name of Abu Hassan al-Ash'ari, who decided to follow Imam Ahmad in his doctrine, yet they are following in truth the Mu'tazila. This is the fact.